kind of gets on you. You really never get rid of it. You know, it's just, I mean, there's a reason why they say that if you have a spider would spin a web that's an inch wide.
Yeah.
It could stop a 747 mid-flight.
They say that, huh?
It's true.
Really?
In science. I'm just telling you. It's, go look it up
on your
Facebook thing there.
So, Dr.
So what you're saying is that's why Jamie couldn't help herself but to call
it. Probably. And that kind of goes back to our, are you fragile or resilient? Because spider webs are both.
Yes.
They're very fragile. You can knock them down in a heartbeat, but they're resilient because by the next hour, there's a brand new one up. You're like, well, I just took that thing down.
You answered the way I wanted to answer.
Exactly.
On yourself.
All right. He's Dr. Josh Klapo, UAB clinical psychologist. Proud to have him. Of course, we've been friends for about 3 or 4 years. We've got a great chemistry. We're good buddies, and we know our families and everything else. We decided we want to do the show about relationships called The Web, But Love, Lust, and Life. And we've had an absolute blast doing it. We got some great phone calls. We had CBS 42's call just a few minutes ago from WIAT, and we had to get to break, but we got a couple more phone calls on hold. We'll get to those in our phone calls. Really bring up some topics that, quite frankly, we don't even see coming. So it's good. We've been talking about some baggage tonight.
Yeah.
We talked about skeletons. And so I was trying to think, is there something that I could divulge? Listen.
Look how much he's opening up just as a function of this show.
One of the common curses of a comedian, and I don't consider myself a comedian, but I've been told that I'm pretty funny. And I'm funny when I don't have to be funny. If I get hired out at the comedy club, I'm probably going to bomb. If people go, hey, we want you to talk to our group because we think you're funny, then I'm doing a stand-up routine. It's going to bomb. But if I go to a funeral, I'm hilarious.
Are you really?
So I'm always doing things. And I'm thinking about ratings. I'm thinking about radio. I'm thinking about people. What was going to keep people through break? And so I thought at 8 o'clock that I'm going to divulge something that happened to me 21 years ago that even my wife doesn't know about. And let me get comfortable here.
We don't have a couch.
I'm going to divulge it here on the web, right. For sake of further ratings, and I don't think this will really shock a lot of people because back in the day, I got after it.
Okay. Now you know I can't hold this.
You didn't know me back in my heyday.
No.
I mean, I was an animal.
No, but I knew when I first moved here.
I mean, anything went. I mean, I'd do anything once as long as I didn't hurt anybody but me.
No, when I first moved here in '99, I heard you because I listened to classic rock and your reputation. I mean, it was beside Alabama, Auburn. You know, we knew about. I knew about Tony Curry.
Yeah.
So that was absolutely.
So all right. So 21 years ago, I was in a pornographic movie.
Really?
Does that surprise you?
Yeah. I don't know that I believe it.
Let me tell you how it went down because. Now, that actually could have been the song that was played, but there's a reason why it's not.
Were you an extra?
Actually, the song that was being played was Kashmir from Led Zeppelin. In this particular porno movie that I was in. And I didn't even realize that I was in a pornographic movie until about 3 years ago.
Okay. Tell me more about that.
When a young lady approached me at one of my gigs I do. Mm-hmm. It may have been a Bud Light game night or something. And she said, listen, I got to tell you something. I was watching a video the other night with my boyfriend. And you were in it. And I'm thinking, yeah. Now you're talking about a guy that's got 3 kids, have been married 14 years. Hold on a second. I know my wife's probably falling off the couch right now.
Yeah.
Just hold on. Let me explain. That's another thing. Well, you didn't ask. Well, this is the other one. Let me explain.
Come clean, my friend.
So she's watching this movie that's pretty grainy.
Okay.
I said, where'd you get it? She said, probably a Video Express, something like that. I said, really? I said, you know. And so there is a guy and a girl in the movie.
Yeah.
And they're getting it on.
Mm-hmm.
And in the background, they have the radio on.
Ah.
And just about the time the fireworks go off, you get me saying, Classic Rock 99.5, Tony Curry, that's Kashmir, Led Zeppelin. So really, we talk about, you know, it's a TMZ world we live in. People want to be notoriety. I think everyone wants to be a little nasty. Wow, Kim Kardashian, she does what? She sent a picture. So I can also say I was in a porno movie.
Dude, that's the cleanest dirt.
Did you like that?
That was the cleanest dirt I've ever...
Very truthful. It's the first time I've let it be known, and it's out there. You could probably rent this movie. So... somewhere, wow. Someone made a porno movie in this town, and she said she got it in a Video Express, so it's not something that was sold out of the trunk of a car.
No.
But she said, and you were on it. And I could hear your voice saying, hey, this is Tony Curry, classic rock. And I'm like, wow. And, you know, I was kind of proud.
Well, because
it's the first movie I was in, you know, yeah. It's pretty impressive.